community is the most important thing. Every single place that we went, we found the similar bonds between those community spaces. And here now, we've formed another community yet again. And so, you know, look up to the person to your left, look to the person to your right, that whole thing, and just know that this is a community now. And going forth, you can help Gordon Plaza, you can help the Houma Nation, you can look and continue into your backyard and continue this struggle. These are just, you know, a few stories of many stories that there are. So for me, that was the biggest lesson, was like this community. We're the ones who are going to make things happen.
Thank you for that. Ms. Shannon,
could you speak about how the residents of Gordon Plaza may have a similar connection to the land here in New Orleans, and how that plays into the relocation demands that you all have?
The similarity is where that it's not where we were placed on our land, it's where the land was sold to us, and we didn't know anything about it. We were able to find out about the land after they sold it to us, but the problem that we had that was almost similar to what you all had is that because we had to fight also. We had to fight for a fully funded relocation. We had to fight because our politicians put us on this land without our knowledge. And when we found out about this land, it was, when we found out about it, it was hard for us to bring to the attention of those who put us on the land, and it wasn't easy as we thought it would have been for them to say, okay, we put them here, let's get them off. No, it wasn't easy at all. We went through five different mayors, and now we're going through our sixth one, which is Cantrell, and we are still fighting. And it's not fair to us because we didn't ask for this. This was given to us. And so and we're still fighting. And you have to continue to fight. You can't just stop, because if you stop, they're not gonna care, because they're getting what they wanna do, what they want. So we have to continue to fight to get what we want and make them understand why we are fighting, the causes we are fighting. We're fighting to save our lives along with the fight that we're doing.
That's powerful.
Thank you for that.
Yeah, sure.
I just want to stand up on behalf of what Ms. Shannon just said, that if when we fight, we win.
That's right.
When we fight, we win.
I loved in the movie there was such a tone of resistance and standing strong and standing in what everybody believed in. Donny, what do you think that, how do you feel about the communities represented and how they may, you know, connect to your community?
I see a lot of similarities in connection with our community. Every time you see a situation like this, it's the same tactics deployed, it's the same situations. You have people signing paperwork that they don't understand, or they don't even speak the language it's written in. Then you have, once the companies actually get there, they don't do anything to replace anything that they've damaged. Like in our communities, they dig canals through the swamps and the marsh, and that invites coastal erosion. We're already losing a football field an hour of land due to erosion and sea level rise, and here they are just digging these canals, letting salt water in, killing off the plants that hold the soil, and it's just all washing away. And you see that, it's the same tactics everywhere. The companies that cause the damage are never held liable. The governments support the companies. And you know, there was one of them that really struck home. They said that with the company came jobs and economic development, and the damage wasn't discovered until later. And we see that in our communities all the time.
Do we have any questions from the audience? You can stand. Yeah, yeah.
Hi, the question I have is, how do you think
truly can get people to understand it's not a them problem. Because oftentimes I feel like it's the same people, even like probably watching this right now. Oftentimes, I'm an activist myself, I find myself preaching to the choir, right? And people don't understand, even if you're in your wealthy neighborhood, your gated community, what is happening to my the children in my community, what's happening to my water and my air, is gonna impact you. That even if you keep your children in the gated community, when they go to college, they're gonna be on the same streets with my children. At some point, they're gonna drink the same water my children drink. At some point, they're gonna breathe the same air that my children breathe. How do we get people to understand that the issues that impact my community will impact you if you live on this planet with me? That's the question. I'm sorry, and I know that's a loaded
question. Do you have anybody in particular you want to ask, or you want just...
Anybody.
Okay. Anybody taken? How do we bring it to the front door? Who's going to take that?
All right, I'll take it. One, if you got kids, invite them to use cell phones. Like, you can tell stories. We have so much access to the ability to tell our own stories for the first time. You know, we can record ourselves, we can put those stories out, we can continue to tell it. And for the first time, we have the ability to make it so that these corporations aren't the one dictating the message. So I believe we have these incredible children rising up and starting it. So talk to your kids. If there are any kids here, talk to your elders, talk to the people around you. It's that community space. And it's true, it's everything affects it. In Arizona, we have uranium mining, and these open pit uranium mines, all they are covered with concrete. That water gets shipped all across the Southwest. That water is contaminated with uranium. It means the Southwest is unknowingly being poisoned by radiation at all times. Nobody knows because it's a native problem. And so with films like this, with stories, with having these situations, with having these community groups, we hope that you tell 10 of your friends and they tell 10 of their friends, and eventually these politicians, these people who are using relocation on my people as a weapon and using the inability to relocate as a weapon against others. These corporations are the ones who are in charge, but they don't have to be. We have the power, we have the voices, we have the people, and it's us. Think about different ways to work in wind power in your communities. Think of different ways to work in building recycling. You look at places like in Egypt, they have the most comprehensive recycling program in the entire world. And it was started because of a caste system of people living in these trash heaps who started to recycle. It wasn't the government, it wasn't anyone else who did it. It was the people. And I know if you've been an activist for a long time, it feels tiring and exhausting, but you're not alone. We're all here standing in support and solidarity with you. And again, keep talking about these issues, because our voices are going to become overwhelming. And that's the point when nobody can ignore us anymore.
I think it's just getting to the point where people in New Orleans understand that our area that we live in, with the toxic land that the houses was built on top of, the water that travels through from Katrina, mm-hmm. all the water that traveled through our neighborhood traveled through your neighborhood, your neighborhood, your neighborhood, and your neighborhood, which brought all the toxic to everybody's neighborhood. So it travels. It travels through the water you take a bath with, the water you drink. It travels. So I see now that our younger people is paying more attention to it now than our older people. So I think it's gonna get better sooner than what it has been.
Yes, sir. You wanna come up and ask on the mic, or you wanna put your
sure.
Okay.
I do.
It doesn't go far.
It's more of a shout out than a question. I want to ask all the residents of Cordo Plaza to stand up, please, because they are really in the fight in the area. you all for making this documentary, and a big shout out to my friend Mel Cardona, who is the director of photography, who is way too humble and will never take credit for this, but I think they deserve it. Thank you. You guys are the ones holding the fight in the city, and we all should look up to you and support you. It's the least that we can do.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Sure. One, thank you for all of this. It was incredible. It's beautiful to see on stage, like on the big screen. It's beautiful to see and hear all of you, the residents of Gordon Plaza present. Thank you for all the work that you put into each and every part of community. I think also we use the word community a lot. And I'd love to hear from you all what that actually means and like what community means to you, so that we could hear in your own terms, because also what community means in maintaining all of the action and all of the fight and all of the morale.
To me, community, with my community that I live in, it was, from the beginning, it was a struggle at first. We all tried to get together to start this fight when it first happened. But it takes courage, it takes strength, and it takes patience. Because when you're ready to start to fight for your community, everybody else is not going to be ready. So what you have to do, you have to continue. And as time go on, it's going to grow. And then it's going to continue to grow. It started with just me by myself, until I went to another community meeting, not knowing that Marilyn and Ludwina was fighting for the same thing. So we were able to get together and get our community on one accord. And today we stand strong. We stand in solidarity. Yeah. Because we're all fighting for the same thing. Yeah. Yeah. We know what we want. Yeah. We know what we're not gonna take. Yeah. I mean, majority of the times I know you see Miss Ludwina, Miss Marilyn, Jesse, you see them out there fighting because they're fighting for what they want. They're fighting for what they stand. They're fighting for what they think they should have because they didn't ask to go to get put on this types of landfill. But you don't see me because I'm the only one that has to go to work. But when I'm not there, they are.
Yeah.
So this is what community means to me and my community, along with Mr. Jesse and Miss Ludwina.
I wanna, can I, gotta say something to that. I gotta speak.
Yes.
Okay, just to keep it simple, community to us, very good. Shannon, thank you. That was good, really good answers. Community is, for us, it's not just our immediate community, but those, all of those that stand in solidarity with us, even outside of our community, who has formed a community, as well as a family, okay? And to be very specific, we have grown and picked up another family by the name of the People's Assembly.
Yes.
And,
yes.
And I tell you, you know, it's a blessing to have them to come into our lives. Okay, you're talking about community, solidarity, standing together, strong, even though we didn't have the numbers that, you know, you would typically think you would need to advance this struggle that we're currently in right now. So community is all of us standing together in solidarity and for the one common cause of, in this case for us, is a fully funded relocation to get people off of toxic soil. So that is community to me, okay? And I don't take it for granted. I love the family that I've inherited, and we're glued together for life. when this struggle is over, our struggle is over, they're gonna still be my family, okay? And we're gonna continue to fight and advance the struggle of others.
Yes.
So this is just not about the residents of Garden Plaza, but it is about the residents of Garden Plaza. And this fight is so important because I think we're setting a precedent for not just the citizens of New Orleans, but throughout this nation, and believe it or not, throughout other parts of the world. Yes. So it's just not about us. So when I speak also again about community, it's about all of us, everybody, throughout the city, throughout this country, and throughout the world as a whole.
Yeah. To the lady with the ring finger.
I'd like to thank the residents of Gordon Plaza for spending some time on a Saturday afternoon at Sampson Park. There were a coalition of young people that were working on and being boots on the ground for cleanup and awareness and that sort of thing. Those young people, ages maybe 12 to 18, 24, are still talking about the fact that you mentioned you've been fighting for over 37 or 40 years. That's as old as some of their parents are. They still talk about the fact that we haven't lost just because we haven't won. Thank you for putting that into the minds of young people that were very different and had never been in that neighborhood before.
You know, the other day, last week, Councilman Morrell.
J.P. Morrell.
He said to us, he said, I was a freshman in college when I first heard about you all. He said, now I'm married with a wife and three kids. He said, y'all still fighting. He said, it shouldn't be. It should have been over a long time ago.
Hi, I'm Ledwina Hurst, and thank you for sharing that story. I was gonna share because we met in Congo Square one Sunday and you told us that story, but that's what it's all about. We want the children to know that you, if there's something you believe in, something you have to fight for, you continue to fight. If you don't fight, you will fall for anything. We have made tremendous progress over the last 6 years since Jesse spoke about community. Since People's Assembly has been involved with us, we have made tremendous progress. And we want people to see that it's important, regardless of the politicians, regardless of what they say their rules are. Rules are made to be broken. They use them for what they you want to use them for. They break them for what they want to break them for. And we have sat there and seen that. Right now, we have sat in all the budget meetings since October of 21. We finally, after constantly sitting in those meetings, was able just last week for the council people to decide to have a meeting about Garden Plaza only. The other meetings we weren't on any of the agendas, but we went in and we disrupted the meetings to get on the agenda, whether our name was there or not. So we want the young people to see that, and we want the young people to know, to be able to, for them to fight for what is right and what is dutifully, rightfully theirs. We're not asking anybody to give us anything. It's what we deserve. We do not have generational wealth in our houses, our homes. We have worked hard to purchase those homes. And as it has been stated, if we were not told that they were on toxic soil, although the politicians knew that when they built it, It was marketed to African American families, which is environmental racism. And so it's important to fight for what you want. Thank you.
Talking about their progress. Celeste, could you tell us where your work is now and the progress?
So my work so far, being growing up in Black Mesa, has always been around and in on the reservation for a good chunk of my life.
It's short, guys.
So right now, basically, for a good part of my life, I've always been working in Arizona and on the reservation. Throughout the entire time, doing a bunch of like student organizing and bringing more awareness to Black Mesa and to Peabody coal mine and the displacement that a bunch of my families and relatives have, you know, firsthand suffered throughout the entire years. Right now, my work has taken me all the way to basically California, is where I reside right now. And the main thing that I have going on in doing this work is I've always been at the forefront in a different way, which is, you know, with the protests in the streets and doing it in that way, which I've done for many years. And right now, being in a more open space and wanting to connect with other communities who are also in the same struggles and in different inner cities, because these things have also majorly affected outside of the reservation, essentially, what people are used to in the inner cities. When you look at Gordon Plaza and everything, it's all the same, exact same process against Black and brown communities. So where my intentions are is to continue to expand and build and learn from these other communities and work and develop these things to also then bring these new knowledges back to my own homelands to continue to fight there as it continues. We're still in the place of big restoration. You know, the land I remember as a kid isn't the same land that I visit, you know, even, you know, being in California for 2 years, it's not the same. And where I'm at right now as an Indigenous healer and body worker is to continue to look at our generational trauma and how we continue to hold these things not only within the land, but how we continue our relationship with the land and how it continues to have an effect on our bodies. So as I continue to develop and learn within different communities, it all comes back to how we heal as a community. And what community means is us holding each other together and working all these things together and looking at our big differences and realizing that they're very, very similar. And we've always been taught to work against each other. We're always taught to be competitive with each other because that is what colonization is. And historically and indigenously, we're never like that. For us as a Diné person, like which is just relationships within one another, how I have relationships with people here in all the way in New Orleans, and I never even knew it, but it still touches in that same exact story. You know, even how you can feel all these people speaking a different language that a lot of these people in the room never heard or understand, you can still feel the tone, you can still feel it, because it's all so similar and we've all felt those things throughout our entire lives. So the biggest project is, full circle, is working with other Filipino communities that I've been gratefully being able to touch in a different way. Long story short, basically, right now working on a Black Indigenous POC healing space up in Clear Lake, California, to have a space of sanctuary for holding and holding those spaces in what we feel as a community. Because as we look at the world as a whole, it's built to break us down and to continue to break us apart from one another. So having these intentional spaces is another part that I've developed and continue to learn as another source and another way for us to continue to work towards these bigger goals and our bigger projects. So that's kind of the biggest thing. And that's where I'm gratefully being able to continue to work and continue to learn and grow as we do, as community does. That's the only thing we can do, is to continue to this dialogue continuously and being able to be here and to learn these things that I never knew before and to just connect in a certain way is the only thing that continues to drive us as a community.
Take two more questions if we have them, all the way in the back and right on the side.
Hi y'all. I just wanted to thank the filmmakers and local folks who helped bring us together here to help everyone share their stories, because I feel like with organizing, it takes like two parts. You know, you need like the sharing of the stories and like the education so you can take action. And I really want to just be like thankful for having the opportunity to hear all of these powerful stories directly, because it seems like whenever I'm hearing stories about environmental damage, that story gets told through nonprofits and NGOs that have their own messaging. But I feel like in this space, we're able to get a chance to like make those direct connections. And it really comes through in the film that, like, you know, it's about these direct connections. So since this space has been connected through this culture making, we're now together talking about these similar issues on the local, regional, national, international level. How do we get to that second part of organizing, which is the action? So like what action is needed like directly, locally, in the immediate sense, and also regionally and nationally that we in this room can kind of plug into to kind of like help make that circle complete when we talk about community. So we've gotten the message. How do we like feed back into that?
Anybody have any ideas how we feed back into this?
Do you have any direct things that you want to ask for right now?
As far as how do we donate or support the work of the United Houma Nation and Gordon Plaza?
For the residents of Gordon Plaza, we ask everyone to email the mayor's office, call the mayor's office, call your city council person, and let them know that, you know, it's time. Time is overdue. It's time for a fully funded relocation for the residents of Gordon Plaza.
When you see her at the second line.
Yeah, evil guests. When you're at the second line, when she's at the second line, when she's at Berkeley's, when she's on St. John's. Residents of Garden Plaza. Not today, not yesterday, but all the way back.
That's right, yes.
4 years ago when you first got in.
Yeah.
Anyone wanting to help out or donate to the United Houma Nation, you can do it via our website, www.unitedhoumanation.org. And just one of the main things we've been struggling with for years, probably as long as Gordon Plaza has been fighting, is our struggle for federal recognition. Mm-hmm. We've been fighting, and it hurts us as far as getting the assistance after a storm, getting the assistance after an oil spill, getting assistance in helping our tribal communities and elders who need that assistance. So if anybody got any pull with that, we'd also welcome that. But yeah, again, thank everybody for being here, and we really appreciate it. Yep, okay.
All right, we got our last question right up there. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you. I'm so grateful for having had this opportunity to see the film, and on a small level, I've come into clarity about the supporting Gordon Plaza through my work in, on a small level with the People's Assembly. I'm telling you, I told them yesterday, I can't be more proud. And one of the things I see similar with what the film showed going through all the different areas was the power of the elders, that we both need to be, all need each other. It has to be intergenerational, because it's like we'd say, you know, when you're old, when you're young, you don't realize the wisdom you have, the